So the next question is given on the board, where it is said that there's a body which is on a horizontal plane. Okay, take it as a horizontal surface. And force of 25 Newton is acting on the body. It is making an angle of 53 degrees to the direction of motion. You can take it either way. This is the direction of motion, 53 degrees up or 53 degrees down. And why that angle 53 is because it has got a rounded off value when you find the sine and cos of it. This has been already mentioned once before. Sine 53 is equal to 0.8. And then cos 53 is equal to 0.6. Now, which is 0.8 and which is 0.6 is something which will cause confusion. Further, the hint already I have given that is that when the angle increases, then the sine value also will increase. When the angle increases, the cosine value decreases. So that is why for a particular value, say 53 degrees, when we have got 0.8 and 0.6, for sine the value should be more and for cosine the value should be less. So remember it like that. So for sine 53, that will be 0.8 and 0.6 will be for cos 53. Okay. So now it is given that there is a horizontal surface. A block is kept on that horizontal surface. There is a force which is making an angle of 53 degrees from the direction of motion. And the value of that force is 25 newtons. Then there is another force of 20 newtons that is acting at 37 degrees. Other things are understood, they are the same like before. So it is 37 degrees to the horizontal. And that force is 27, sorry, it is 20 newtons and acting at an angle of 37 degrees. For all this given data, what is the total force along the motion is one question. And apart from that, what is the condition for which this body will ever remain horizontal? So that now we have already seen that for any force, if you find the components, one is in the horizontal direction and the other one is in the vertical direction. Then for the horizontal direction, it is cos. So this is 25 cos 53. So will be equal to 25. And you can see that cos 53 is 0.6. So it will be 25 into 0.6 newtons, which is equal to 15 newtons. So the horizontal force because of 25 newtons is 15 newtons. And then let us see as to what is its component horizontally. Even before that, we will first find out for the 25 newton force, what will be its vertical component. So for the vertical component, the same 25 newton force the angle with the horizontal is of course 53. Then on the opposite side we have already seen that if it is cos in one direction, that cos is in the angle is along the angle and the other one is going to be therefore sine. So here we will have 25 sine 53, which is equal to sine 53 is 0.8, so it is going to be 25 into 0.8 newtons and that will be equal to 20 newtons. Okay. We will now see the other force. It is given in the question that the other force is 20 newtons at an angle of 37 degrees, which is also shown in the earlier diagram. So, for 20 newton force, the angle is 37. So in the horizontal direction, it is going to be 20 into cos 37, which is equal to 20 into. Then the other force is said to be making an angle of 37 degrees from the body which is horizontal, or you can straight away tell it is making an angle of 37 degrees to the horizontal. So for this, the horizontal component will be 20 into cos of 37, which will be 20 into cos 37 will be the other way around. Cos 53 is 0.6. So 37 is less than 53. For cos, if the angle is less, value will be more. So we get cos 37 will be equal to 0.8, and sine 37 for lesser angles, sine will be lesser. So sine 37 will be equal to 0.6. So we now have cos 37 to be equal to 0.8, and that will be equal to 16 newtons. Then the vertical component. The vertical component will be for 20 newtons, which is making an angle of 37 degrees to the horizontal, will be 20 cos in the direction of the angle, and we have seen it a number of times, so I'll write it as such. It is going to be sine 37. So this 20 sine 37 will be 20 sine 37 is 0.6. So many newtons it is. So it's also equal to 12 newtons. So let us see what is the total horizontal force. One is 15 newtons, and the other one in the horizontal direction is 16 newtons. So what we can therefore tell is that the total horizontal force is equal to 15 plus 16 newtons, which is equal to 31 newtons. Then in the vertical direction, we have seen that because of one force, the value is 25 sine 53, which is equal to 20 newtons. And because of the other force in the vertical direction, we have seen it is 20 sine 37, which is equal to 12 newtons. So the total vertical force will be given by total vertical force. Is equal to 1 which is total vertical force. One is 20 newtons and the other one is 12 newtons, so it is going to be 20 plus 12 newtons, which is equal to 32 newtons. What is the meaning of this? When will the body remain horizontal? That is possible if the total vertical force is balanced by the total downward force. If there is no force acting downwards, then the weight only will act downwards. So if the weight is more than 32 or at least equal to 32 newtons, then both upward and downward force will be balanced. So the body will remain horizontal. So the condition that the body should remain horizontal is that the upward force should be equal to 32 newtons, or else if there are some more forces acting down along with the weight, then what we have to say is that if 32 newton force which is acting upwards is balanced by the total downward force, then the body will remain horizontal. There will be no movement in the vertical direction because in that direction the forces. So in the first question shown here, you can see that there are two equal forces. And those equal forces, let it be equal to, say, P. And the the forces are acting on a particle. We have to find out what is the angle between the two particles such that the square of the resultant is equal to 3 times the product. Please note, product means multiplication. So, multiplication of these two and 3 times that will be equal to the square root, square of the resultant. So, it is 3p multiplication of the product. 3 times that product is equal to the resultant square. So, that will be equal to 3p square. So, this is given. For the time being, setting it aside, then what we also know is that r square is equal to p square, another p square plus q square it is, but that second force being also equal to p, so we will take it as such, p square plus 2 into p into q, that will be again equal to p, and then angle between the two forces is equal to cos alpha. Here it is given that r square is equal to 3p square. P square plus another p square is 2p square. And the same way here, p into p is p square, so it becomes 2p square again, and then cos alpha is also there. Bring 1, 2p square to the other side. So then what we will have is 2p square cos alpha will be equal to 3p square minus 2p square is equal to p square. So, cancelling out p square on both sides of the equation, then only 1 will remain here. So, we will get therefore cos alpha, 1 remains here, then this 2 going the other side becomes 1 by 2. When cos alpha is equal to 1 by 2, then it means that from trigonometry, alpha will be equal to 60 degrees, which is the answer. And when you look into the next question, where it is given that there are two forces and we will have to find its magnitude. But what is given about the two forces is that when they are acting at 90 degrees, that is right angles, then the resultant is root 10 newtons. And when the two forces act at an angle of 60 degrees, then the resultant is root 13. This is all what is given. So, looking into this question now, again, taking the equations. We have got magnitude of two forces. Here, note that the forces are not equal. So, we have to consider two different forces here. So, we have got one is P, square of that, taking the equation that is there for the magnitude, we have now got Q square. And after that, if they act at 90 degrees, so angle between them is 90, so we will get cos 90. The resultant is root 10. Here we want resultant square. So it will be root 10 whole square. And root 10 whole square is square, and the root will get nullified. So the result is just 10. Cos 90 is 0. We know that. So the first equation we will get is p square plus q square plus 0 is equal to 10. So, this is the equation number 1. Thereafter, what is given is that if they act at 90 degrees, sorry, if they act at 60 degrees, the resultant is root 15. So, taking an angle of 60 degrees, write down another equation. Also, we have got p square plus q square plus 2 into P into Q into cos 60. And now the resultant is root 13. Everywhere we have got square. So for resultant, you have to take R square, and R square will be equal to square root of 13 square, which is 13 itself. And from here, well, what we will get for by further solving is R P square plus q square then plus cos 60 is half, also seen it number of times. So 1 by 2 multiply 2, there will be cancellation, only PQ will remain. So we will get plus PQ alone is equal to 13. Call this as equation 2. And then what you can do is that equation 2 minus equation 1. See what we will get. Equation 2 minus equation 1, P square plus Q square. Both equations will get cancelled. Only PQ will remain. 13 minus 3 on the other side will be. So from 1 and 2, therefore, from 1 and 2, what we will get is only PQ will remain when you subtract equation 2 from equation 1. And on the other side, 13 minus 10 will be equal to only 3. So we have got a good result. Then what we will do is, if you want, you can also number this equation as equation number 3. Well, P square plus Q square plus 2PQ is equal to P plus Q the whole square. Here, P square plus Q square is 10 and PQ is 3. So 2PQ will be 3 into 2, 6. So this is 10 plus 2 into 3 is equal to P plus Q the whole square. This is 6, 10 plus 6 is 16, here we have got 16 P plus Q whole square. So here also try to find a square. 16 is 4 square. So you can put the equation like this, 4 square is equal to P plus Q whole square. So or 16 that is equal to 4 square is equal to the P plus Q the whole square. So taking square on both sides, we will get therefore P plus Q is equal to 4. We'll call it as equation number 4 if you want, or just like that, leave it. And then proceeding further, what we will now get is that P square plus Q square minus 2PQ, take it, 2PQ will be equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB formula, and from that we will get P minus Q the whole square. Simplifying this, we get P square plus Q square is 10 and minus PQ is 3, so it will be 2 into 3 and that will be equal to P minus Q the whole square. 2 into 3 is 6, so this will be 10 minus 6, which is equal to 4. And 4, of course, we know it is square, so it will be equal to P minus Q, the whole square. And taking square root both sides, we will get P minus Q is equal to 2. If you want, call it as equation 5, others just leave it. Now you can see from 4 and 5, if you add both of them, plus Q minus Q will get cancelled and we will get 2P is equal to 4 plus 2, 6. So, from 4 and 5, what we will get is that 2P is equal to 6. Therefore, P will be equal to 3 newtons, units, whatever you call it. If P is 3, by taking equation 4 or 5, anyone, if P is 3, then 2 will come here, 3 minus 2 will become 1, so Q will be equal to 1. Or put P equal to 3 here, take 3 to the other side, Q will be 4 minus 3, which is equal to 1. And Q is equal to 1. So find the magnitude of two forces. We have found out that. Okay. Now, for both the questions, to segregate it properly, this is the first question, and once that is over, we have now got the second question. Starting from here, question number 2. that is all. So second question, Abdul.